Hi there, I'm Jeffrey Gorman. Welcome to my studio. What I'm going to do today with you is give you a tour of the studio, enough of going to my galleries. I'm working on a Raven right now. You can see what I've got mountain bike inner tubes for his body, and then I've cut these pieces of juniper and I'm slowly fabricating the wings. He's going to eventually look like this. What I do is I use photographs to get the idea of what I'm trying to capture with the animal, and that's as detailed as I get when I fabricate these pieces, so that gives you a little idea. As I mentioned, I'm having this survey show in 2015 at a community college gallery in Florida, which I'm pretty excited about. I've been doing it for a whopping 10 years, which isn't a long time. I'm going to include this piece right here. You can see the drawing and the figure. This was an early piece which I called lignin, and lignin is the chemical process in a tree that keeps it straight and keeps it tough. So this is a tree spirit here. And what I do, which is kind of different than most artists, is I do a drawing of the piece after I've completed it. And you know, most artists will have a sketchbook and do something beforehand, but this was done afterwards. You can also see up here in the corner another figurative piece that I did probably 5 years ago. It was based on a book that I read about this adventurer that lived in the marshes of Iraq with the Marsh Arabs in the 1950s, and they were really into falconry. So you can see the falcon on this guy's hand. The book was called The Marsh Arabs, and it was by Wilfred Thysinger. A couple of years ago, I read in the New Yorker about a village in China where they were basically, all they did was paint reproductions of master's painting, and it really fascinated me. At the end of the article, the writer asked one of the Chinese artists what artist inspired them. They said this had nothing to do with art, it was business. So that got my curiosity going. What I did was I sent a digital file of one of my rabbits to a painter in this village. And it took about a month. They returned this painting to me, and if you look at it in detail, it's pretty technically well done. I, of course, made the frame. It's lead with some mountain bike tires on the side and some other various lost and found things. Up here, you can see a dip netter. In Alaska, where I spend time, I've seen them dip netting. The locals are allowed to, they have a certain amount of fish they can get per year. They have these large nets that they dip in waterfalls where the salmon are migrating. He also has a little head that's made out of cedar wood bark. He's kind of amorphic. And over here is kind of a fun piece that I did last summer. I learned how to weld, and I have a baby welder. It's not anything big. So this is a wasp. It's so funny. We seem to be in this bee craze right now. I grew up and intersected with wasps more than bees, and it seems like I was often running away from them. So I made this guy in honor of kind of the bee's nests that maybe I threw rocks at, or the wasps that attacked me over the years. I work on a lot of rabbits. I think of rabbits as the tricksters of the art world. They're the ones that are really getting back at us humans for anything we may have done to them over the years. This rabbit right here is kind of fun. He's got this barbell that I found in an old abandoned building. He's holding that, and then he's on this wonderful tin. Somebody gave me this tin. It's an old marshmallow tin that's probably, I'm guessing, 1930s, 1940s. It makes a great pedestal for him. This rabbit down here is holding an antique croquet ball. People give me a lot of junk. Actually, I'm getting it from all over the country now. And it's really fun because people will send me stuff and it forces me to integrate it into my work. And it's a really nice challenge. So I just made this toucan here. He mounts on the wall, which is kind of fun. It took me about 5 years to figure out how to make this guy, which is really funny. You know, artists, we have our own rules and our own rule book that we use. And I'm pretty strict with those interior rules, so for some reason, it took me 5 years to figure out how to construct this guy. But once I got him, he was somewhat easy to construct. He's got a mountain bike inner tube body that's been wrapped. I painted some white paint on it, then I ran wire over it, and I rusted the wire, so it's given him this wonderful patina on his bib here. And then his bill is just made of old tin cans that I've painted. You can see down here also, I'm roughing out a rabbit body. What I use is I use this hard rigid foam as the core of the piece, and then I add everything else onto it. Another rabbit that I just completed is this guy down here. He has an antique croquet ball. He's also on an old cigar box. Somebody sent me about 10 cigar boxes that they had saved. And the cigar boxes, I think, are a great presentation platform for this guy. In the corner right here, you can also see that I've roughed out the body of a horse. You can see that rigid foam that I use. And then I'll really sculpt it and get the shapes that I want, and then I'll start adding the armatures on there. It's funny being a full-time artist now. Every kid that grew up did art, and I imagine it was a way to teach them how to learn and to supposedly color between the lines. Of course, I never colored between the lines. In fact, I colored on the wall a lot. So what I feel like in being an artist now is it's really taking me back to my childhood and where there weren't a lot of rules about what you did, and that's really what I go by in this studio.